Well, I mean, we wanted to bring a lot from the first one, and in particular the template, because we realized, like, what people loved about the first one was, yes, it's a very funny movie, it's hilarious, but there's also a mystery element to the first one that I think helped the movie work so well. It's an investigative comedy in a weird way, and we definitely wanted to keep that alive. And then outside of that, we really just wanted to amplify everything, amplify the comedy, amplify the situations, and amplify the obstacles that these guys have to go through. That scene we shot here, because quite honestly, that's just so many pages and such a big scene, that to be able to shoot that on a stage where you could pull walls out and move around, it's just made a lot more sense than to shoot it there. So that was the first thing we shot, which was difficult because when you shoot movies out of order, obviously, you know, so they woke up first, then we pack everything up and we moved to Bangkok. And but like, you know, from the first Hangover and in this one, that wake up scene is kind of iconic because it's where all the little, every little thing actually means something ultimately, you know, every little thing is kind of a clue. I love shooting some of that car chase stuff. I love shooting the, I like shooting scenes with all the guys, meaning these three guys and Chow. You know, he added a whole nother dynamic to that threesome that for me was always, those were always great days, was when Chow was with them. Well, he's such a fearless, phenomenal actor. He brings so much that we wanted to give him a little more to do. No, my guy is, you know, my guy's the same guy in every movie, this guy Barry, but he is a sex offender, so he could not get a passport. We just lock ourselves in a room, like, for a summer, and we just constantly one-upping each other and throwing ideas out, and wouldn't this be funny, and why would this, why doesn't that work, and da-da-da. And it's just this back and forth. It's always hard to explain writing to somebody. It just always sounds insane. But it's sometimes it's as simple as thinking of an image like a monkey in a vest with a smoking a cigarette. That just starts there, and then you realize why. Let's just put it in the movie, and we'll figure out why he's there. You know what I mean? And other times it's a little bit more involved, and it's a scene. Or so we're just constantly pitching each other ideas. You know, sometimes you have an animal and scenes a dog and it's just going to sit there, like, you know, this monkey was asked to do a lot, so she had a great trainer and she just worked her butt off as far as like figuring things out. I don't know, it was kind of amazing to have her on set, and she just became part of the crew. She would fall asleep in your hands, like she would just sit in my hands sometimes and just fall asleep in between takes while we're waiting for stuff, and we all fell in love with her. It was a lot harder than any of us had anticipated, and mainly just because of the crowds and the heat and the chaos that comes with a place like Bangkok. It really is. I love chaos. Our movies are always about chaos, but this took it to another level. It was. I think in that respect, it's actually easy to make a sequel. I've never done one before, but in that respect it was easier. Everyone knew their roles, including me, but they all knew what their backstory was because their backstory was the last movie. Like, if you don't know, go watch it. I don't want to talk about it. So it was, in that respect, you're right, it was a lot easier, and we just all gelled really fast.